Tongans in New Zealand are desperately fundraising to keep their loved ones alive to pay for life-saving dialysis treatment, which is free to New Zealanders but not to non-resident Tongans. Patients are spilling over to New Zealand because the Tongan government can't afford a dialysis unit and want to spend its money on diabetes prevention. John Pulu reports.
The village of Vainī, south of Nuku'alofa, is the home of Ana Osai. The 50-year-old mother of two has been handed a death sentence. She has kidney failure and she no longer sees a future with her family. Anna's condition has weakened her. No longer mobile, she's housebound. All that her children have left is hope. Anna urgently needs kidney dialysis treatment. The only problem is she can't get it in Tonga. At Viola Hospital, doctors are doing their best to keep patients like Anna alive. All they can offer her is extra time.
What we're doing at the moment, we're just looking at the reversible stuff, mainly to do with the quality of life. And this is almost sort of terminal care we're providing, palliative care.
Every 3 to 4 weeks, Anna receives the gift of life, donated blood from members of her own family. It gives her a few more precious weeks of health.
Every year, 60 more Tongans need dialysis, but the problem is Tonga's medical experts say this country can't afford a dialysis centre or have the experts to run one.
This is not the right time for dialysis in Tonga. And basically because the cost is prohibitive, so high, and the Tonga government or the Minister of Health Tonga cannot afford to run the dialysis unit.
That's bad news for Anna and her loved ones because she knows she's at the end of the road unless she goes where dialysis is available, probably New Zealand. But like so many Tongans in the same situation, Anna just can't afford it. The most common form of dialysis treatment for people like Anna is hemodialysis. Here's how it works. It filters toxins from damaged or diseased kidneys. When the patient's blood enters the machine, the toxins pass from the blood through a membrane into a special solution called dialysate. The clean blood then returns to the body and the dirty dialysate carrying the toxins is pumped away. It's very effective, but very expensive. So what are the costs? New Zealand spends $150 million on around 2,500 dialysis patients a year. Per patient per year, that's $73,000 for hospital-based hemodialysis and $45,000 for home-based hemodialysis. But if Tonga had dialysis, it would eat up about a third of their $23 million annual health budget. So we can see it's a massively expensive way of prolonging someone's life. But New Zealand does offer dialysis to its residents and to non-residents who can afford to pay. Reverend Sione Malamalavaya has come to New Zealand to save his life. Sione is having a different kind of dialysis which doesn't remove and replace the blood. Instead, the process pumps fluid into the stomach lining, the peritoneum. The fluid then picks up the waste that the kidneys haven't been able to process and the fluid is pumped back out again. It's a different way of doing the work of the kidney but carries the same huge cost. The New Zealand government spends $40,000 per patient per year for peritoneal dialysis. Sione is forking up more than $3,000 a month for his life-saving treatment. Sione is on a visitor's visa, and being a non-resident means he's paying for his own treatment. He's now running out of money and is forced to beg to fund his treatment.
Well, for Allah,
His plea was answered by the community. Church members and businesses came together to donate for his treatment.
We want to help out, to reach out to our people, even though that we are struggling, but we still help each other because that's our Tongan way of trying to help each other.
Sione was too sick to attend his own fundraiser, but his wife was overwhelmed by the $11,000 raised. That is money to fund an extra 4 months of life with her husband.
It's a very hard condition because I know the love from the people is very important. Without love, no life.
As hard as it is for Reverend Vaya, back in Tonga, the numbers of patients continue to grow.
If you want to cure your people from dying of this, you must do something right now.
Onesi Tuifua has late diagnosed diabetes. His bleak future is likely renal failure and a desperate need for dialysis.
That is my question to all the absolute powers here in the country. What are you waiting for? The people dying every day. Your parents, your brothers, your sisters, every day, every week. What are you waiting for?
That waiting is urgent for Anna and her family. In order to survive, she needs people to donate.
Found a girl in you.
I wish nothing but the best.